In this video, we're going to be discussing the key terms for our next unit in the theory of knowledge, which is reason. So to get started, we're going to refresh your memory with a few of the terms that you've already been introduced to, and that's how we gain knowledge. The two you already know about is deductive and inductive reasoning, or the method of deduction or the method of induction in gaining knowledge. Now, just as a quick review, deduction is when we go from the general to the specific, and induction is when we go from the specific to the general. And although these provide us two very good methods of gaining information, there are some fallacies or some problems we need to be aware of. For example, in deduction, when we go from the general to the specific, we can have an invalid argument, or what we call a syllogism, which I'll discuss in just a few minutes. And in the inductive method, we can go to hasty generalizations. So we need to be aware not to jump to too many conclusions and make hasty generalizations, and not to have invalid arguments. Those are the two fallacies we need to be aware of when dealing with deduction and induction. As far as gaining knowledge, two other terms that are important to know. Just to review, rationalism, that's a school of thought where reason is the most important way of knowing and a way to gain knowledge. But then we also have rationalization. And the rationalization is the manufacturing of reasons to justify our beliefs. And while rationalism could be thought of as good, reason is not the sole way of gaining knowledge. And rationalization, although some of your reasons can be manufactured to justify your beliefs, that doesn't mean that they're valid or true. So we're talking about arguments, and this is the deductive way or the deductive method of reason. Whenever we talk about arguments, we talk about rhetoric, and rhetoric is simply the art of persuasive words or writing or thinking. And when we talk about creating an argument from a deductive standpoint, we need to talk about syllogisms. And a syllogism is made up of premises and conclusions, and then we decide whether a syllogism is valid, but doesn't mean it has to be true. So we'll talk about all these in the next slide. So what is a syllogism? Well, it's just an argument that's made up of two premises and a conclusion. There are three terms, each of which occurs twice. And there are quantifiers, such as all, some, or no, which tell us the quantity of what is being referred to. So you see here on the slide, there is an example of a syllogism. It's a constructive argument that is using the deductive method, going from general to specific. Premise one, all dogs are mammals. Premise two, Fido is a dog. Conclusion, therefore, Fido is a mammal. If the conclusion can logically follow from the two premises, then we say that this argument is valid. That's the big thing about arguments, is we need to make sure that we understand that they are valid. Now, this is also true, but those two terms don't have to go together. You can have a valid argument that is very untrue, or an invalid argument that gives you true information. So to get into that, let's go into another syllogism. And this is where we talk about that truth and validity. And this quote is really important. The validity of the argument is independent of the truth or falsity of the premise it contains. So a valid argument and a true argument are not the same thing. And that's really important to understand. So for example, here is an argument. Premise one, all panthers are pink. Premise two, Che Guevara is a panther. C, our conclusion, therefore Che Guevara is pink. Now this is a valid syllogism. If you look at the conclusion, you can logically get that information or deduction from premise one and premise two. However, Che Guevara is a person and he is a panther from the Black Panther movement of the 1960s and he is not pink. So it's an untrue argument, but a valid argument. So that's kind of confusing, but we need to make sure we get both those two terms independent of each other. Some more issues with logic. We have our belief bias. We oftentimes think that arguments are valid if we agree with them or if they somehow are congruent with our frame of knowledge or our schema of knowledge. Enthymemes. Enthymemes are incomplete arguments. For example, a syllogism that's missing a premise. And of course, we've already talked about rationalization, and that's the manufacturing of reasons to justify beliefs. So what I want to go over right now are the 10 deadly fallacies. And these are logical fallacies. We've already talked about hasty generalizations from the inductive method and the invalid syllogisms from the deductive method. So now we're going to flip-flop back to inductive method of reasoning. And we're going to talk about some logical fallacies or when we use errors that we can make in our informal reasoning.